Hi everyone, welcome to Eating Real with Change Food. Today, here we have Chef Ann Cooper. She's a chef, author, educator, and founder of the Chef Ann Foundation. Hi. Okay, so we'll just start. So can you, for anyone who hasn't seen your the TEDx Manhattan talk, can you just explain a little bit about your work with your foundation?
Sure. I actually have 3-day jobs. I'm the director of food services for Boulder Valley School District. We have 31,000 kids in 54 schools. We're doing about 14,000 meals a day, all cooked from scratch. And everything we do is really healthy. Everything made from whole ingredients, no hormones, no antibiotics, trans fats, all that kind of stuff. So that's what I do in the school district. And then with the foundation is 9 years old. We're touching 2.9 million kids. We're working in every state in the nation. We have programs like salad bars to schools and Project Produce and the School Food Support Initiative. But with all of these programs, we're working in every single state and touching 2.9 million kids.
That's awesome. So with Change Food, it is the celebration of Food Month in December. So you sent over a really awesome recipe for matzo cake. And I see that it was your grandmother's recipe. So thank you so much for sharing that. It looks really good, and we're going to share it on YouTube under this video as well. Do you have anything to say about the recipe? Do you make it every year?
Yeah, the thing that's the coolest about the recipe is when I was growing up, my grandparents would make this together, and there's a lot of chocolate and nuts and stuff in it, and they had a hand grinder that my grandfather would attach to the table. I mean, this was before there was food processing and everything, and they ground all the nuts by hand. They ground all the chocolate by hand. Now, of course, you wouldn't do all that, but it's a great recipe. Then my mom had the recipe and wouldn't give it to me, but one of my sisters found my grandmother's recipe, and that's how I got it.
Oh, my gosh. Have you ever made it the way that they used to make it?
No, I don't have a hand grinder.
Oh, yeah, true. That would be difficult to do then. And do you have any other favorite holiday recipes that you make?
You know, that's really the most holiday. I'm almost always traveling during the holidays. So that's really pretty much the one that, you know, is always made around the holiday time.
Yeah. Did your grandmother or your grandparents, like, is that what inspired you to be a chef, or why did you want to become a chef?
I fell into it. You know, I was 20 years old and decided to be a ski bum, and it was the only job I could get, and I fell in love with it.
That's so cool. Are there any other ingredients that you like to use around this time of year, or any spices and herbs like that?
Well, I mean, really especially in Colorado, what we have this time of year is root vegetables and winter squashes. So butternut squash, acorn squash, Cinderella squash, any of the squashes and root vegetables, beets, turnips, rutabagas, things like that. That's the kind of food this time of year.
Yeah, squashes are everywhere in the winter. And do you have any tips for how people can sort of make healthier, conscious decisions during the holidays? When there's
eat
like
real food, eat real food,
simple as that.
That's it.
I love it. All right. Well, that's it. Do you have any updates about anything you're doing that you'd like to share?
Well, you know, it's just in Boulder Valley, we've got 4 more days of school and we're on vacation till January. So right now there's just not a lot going on, but I guess the one thing I would say is the latest project of the Chef Ann Foundation is the School Food Institute, and it's an online institute for people to working in schools or working with schools to help schools segue from highly processed to scratch cooked. And these are all online courses, and you can sign up at theschoolfoodinstitute.org and take classes to help be able to get schools serving really healthy, good food.
That's really great. We'll share that too under this video. Awesome. I love the work you're doing. Well, thank you so much for taking the time to speak with me today.
Okay, my pleasure. Thank you so much.
All right. Bye.
Bye.
I'm going to end the